So around the 1970s, there was a plastic surgeon called Maxwell Maltz. And what he realized, this plastic surgeon, was that some of his patients, their confidence improved dramatically as a result of having had plastic surgery. However, this did not apply to everyone. Many of his patients, they still felt ugly, unattractive, or not enough, even after having had plastic surgery and looking objectively beautiful on the outside. So Maxwell Maltz called these people scarred on the inside, and he realized that if someone's mental image of themselves was as someone unattractive or someone not enough or someone unlovable, then it didn't matter what happened on the outside or how they looked on the outside. They still felt, thought, and acted according to their mental inner image of themselves. So what he did is that he created a visualization to help these people create inner confidence and improve and change their inner image of themselves. And when they did that, this is how their confidence also improved. And this guy, he also wrote this book, Psycho-Cybernetics. It's a great, great book. So visualization is so important. And it also applies to quitting smoking. And it's such a big part of the CBQ program, because when you visualize something in your mind thinks you're experiencing it. And there are two reasons why visualization is so important. First of all, if you see yourself inside as a smoker, it will not matter if you stop yourself from smoking cigarettes with willpower and patches and gums and whatever. If you still see yourself as a smoker, you will eventually go back into acting as a smoker. There will always be a gap between how you see yourself and how you behave inside, and you will feel just not right. You will not feel like yourself, and this is really hard to sustain long term. So becoming a non-smoker starts by changing the mental image of yourself. And by imagining yourself as a non-smoker, visualizing yourself as a non-smoker, visualizing your life as a non-smoker, you create in your mind a new possibility, a new possible future. Because as smokers, when we think about quitting smoking, when we think about life without cigarettes, we usually imagine a painful future, a future that has deprivation, and where you have to deny yourself things you enjoy so that you will not be reminded of smoking. And of course, nobody wants to work towards a painful and undesirable and unhappy future. So by visualizing yourself as a non-smoker and your smoke-free life, you're opening your mind to a new possible future, a future that already exists, this possibility, but you just allow yourself to see it and focus on it. And the second reason why visualization is so important and a part of the CBQ program is because visualization is mental practice. Visualization allows you to experience something in your mind before you experience it in reality. Because the mind, on the neurological, on the physiological level, it cannot tell the difference between imagination and reality. So when you mentally rehearse something, your mind thinks you're experiencing it. So when you mentally rehearse being a non-smoker, feeling like a non-smoker, seeing your life as a non-smoker, experiencing situations as a non-smoker, your body and your mind thinks that this has actually happened. So when it does happen after your quit date, it will not feel an unexpected new thing to you. A part of you will be walking your smoke-free life from experience. And that's also powerful. And that's why top Olympic athletes, they visualize themselves winning, and all the way through their races, they visualize the whole process of the progress and the win. NASA team that went to the moon, they visualized their mission 5 years beforehand. Visualization is mental practice, and there is even research that showed that people who visualized themselves going to the gym had an actual impact on their muscle increase. So visualization works on every level of the body. Now, what if you cannot visualize? Listen, everyone can visualize in different ways. Some people focus on more intense emotions. Other people see clearer images. Other people focus on what they hear. but everyone can visualize in their own way. So when I say visualize, I want you to think about imagining in any way you can. So if right now I ask you, what color is your car? Or what color is your house from the outside? If you're not actually standing in front of your house right now and you're able to recall the color, then you visualized. So visualization means imagining in any way you can. It's constructing a mental representation of something. Now I want to share with you a step-by-step visualization exercise that will help you start visualizing and imagining yourself as a happy non-smoker. And when I say happy non-smoker, I don't mean quitting smoking and being happy all the time for no reason. That's totally unrealistic and not what we're aiming for. And even though research shows that people do become happier after quitting smoking, when we say happy non-smoker, we mean being happy with and about your decision to live free from addiction. So that's what a happy non-smoker means. It means someone who's not deprived, who's not missing cigarettes every day. We don't want that. So let's do the visualization exercise. So start by allowing yourself to relax. Lower your shoulders, soften your jaw, and the more you relax, the more you open your mind and you open your imagination. And when you're totally relaxed and you can close your eyes anytime you want to or pause the video anytime you want to, now imagine the real you standing right in front of you. The real you is the happiest, healthiest, freest, most confident version of yourself. The real you is this non-smoker you, is the smoke-free you. It's the you that you are when nobody's watching. It's the you that lives beyond fear. And take a moment to really appreciate and feel totally happy and satisfied and fulfilled with who the real you is. And notice, how do they walk? How does the real you talks, acts? What do they wear? How does the real you holds their body and talks to people and approaches problems and goes after their goals and their desires? Notice how the real you lives their life. What attitude do they have? And when you have noticed everything you need to notice about the real you, now step into the you in front of you and merge with it. Become one. And see now, through the eyes of the real you. Hear through the ears of the real you, and feel how it feels like to live life as that person. And more, start really imagining the real you encountering and handling situations in your life, present situations, past situations, and future situations, and allow your body to feel and totally be full with feelings of joy and confidence and freedom. The more you see yourself acting and becoming the real you. Take as long as you want with this, and as soon as you're ready, come back, open your eyes, and keep everything you felt and learned from this visualization. So that's it. This is so powerful because many times people tell me, and this is very reasonable, they tell me, how can I imagine myself as a non-smoker? I've been smoking all my life. I've been a smoker longer than I've been a non-smoker. Well, if you cannot imagine yourself as a non-smoker, just imagine yourself as the healthiest, happiest, freest, most confident, liberated version of yourself, because that's who you are as a non-smoker. And being a non-smoker is not turning into someone else. It's going back to your real self. You were born to be a non-smoker. It's your birthright. This is your natural state. So by quitting smoking, you're going back to your real self. So if you boost that with a visualization and help yourself mentally with that inner image, you will get there. And of course, if you want to learn more about the CBQ program and the actual four stages that take you from a smoker to a happy non-smoker, because visualization is part of stage one, which is the decision to quit smoking. So if you want to learn more about the CBQ method, check the links below this video. If you want to learn more about the CBQ program, which is how you can apply the CBQ method, not by yourself, but with our program, I will put the links for that as well. Thank you so much for watching, and I will see you next time. If you want to quit smoking in a way that's easy, natural, and permanent, then you need to check out the CBQ method. The cognitive behavioral quitting method is based on psychology, and it has helped millions quit smoking and vaping in just four steps, in just four stages. The four stages of the CBQ method reprogram your brain and remove your desire to smoke so you can quit easily and naturally, even if you've tried everything but nothing has worked for you, and even if you've been smoking all your life and smoking is all you know. To learn more about the CBQ method and see how it can help you quit smoking for good, go to startcbq.com. This page is for you if you're trying to quit smoking and you want to see how this step-by-step process works, or if you've recently quit but you're struggling. This page will show you how the CBQ can help you and how to get started for free. So go to startcbq.com to learn more, and I'll see you there.